You're an entrepreneur.
Yes.
You are in the heart of that. Most of the entrepreneurs don't look like you and don't have that tremendous A statement necklace at all. Well, except for Zuckerberg sometimes does wear one. But how do you look at it as an entrepreneur? Because you had to go out, raise money, difficult, easy, what?
Well, I think I actually hear what both of you are saying, and I come down more on the view that if you're an individual trying to build a career, that you should generally ignore your gender and proceed with the assumption that the world is awaiting for your success.
Right.
So while the...
Okay, I'm gonna take issue with that, but go ahead.
While there are issues, I don't think that having that in your head every day serves you in any way. Doesn't mean you don't go out and better the advancement of women in the workplace, but I look at it too on a more macro timeline and perspective. Right? Women have been, we've been around in our modern form for 40,000 years. Women have had equal roles in the workforce in the last 30, 40. I mean, we have won the lottery on the history of time to be here now. I graduated in Silicon Valley at the birth of the internet in 1994. I mean, how lucky am I? I mean, that doesn't feel like a disadvantage. It feels like I won the lottery. So I go around generally ignoring the fact that people are not quite open-minded or don't expect women in every roles. But when you think about it on a more macro perspective, you're like, you know, we're doing pretty good. And I, too, with two daughters, think that their opportunity and the way that they look at the world gets better and better and better every single day. So I really think that for women, I try to focus on the flexibility that can exist in leadership roles inside of a company as a way to make sure that more women are advancing, because that's the one thing that I can do and control in the world to help advance that. But as an entrepreneur, I have personally never felt discriminated against or that it was a barrier. And there probably were biases all around me. I just chose to ignore them and keep going.